Oh, hi, this is Lisa Swank, and I thought I'd try and I'm just gonna shut the door here. Do this toilet tissue. Gina has, I'll try and link it. It's one of her older videos, and she used toilet tissue. Excuse me, to make some embellishments. And the design group is doing Gina stamps on tissue and collaging it down. But, you know, it's what got me thinking about the toilet tissue is in one of the swap boxes, there were these little black, I didn't know what it was. Apparently it's for bookmaking. But I saved one so I can use it for, you know, I can use it to make a circle or make a heart. But I got to thinking that, you know, I wonder if I could do a mold with it. So I've wet some toilet tissue and put that in there. And it just happenstance that when I popped on YouTube last night, somebody, I don't know, in my feed or whatever it's called on YouTube, here was this toilet tissue demo. Somebody must have watched it. And I watched it. It's only about 13 minutes long, but I watched it and I thought, what a great idea. And I'm going to try it with her stamps. And I have some underneath this book pressing. Maybe I can do the butterfly. I'm probably going to get some of that black ink off of there, but that's probably okay. So here, I've just, you know, it's a, I don't know how many sheets that is, probably about 8. And remember, I'm just experimenting. Oh, goodness. All of a sudden, I got a tickle in my throat. That's allergies for you. And then I wet the toilet tissue. Maybe I can take that. Not soggy, but just wet. And I put the stamp on there like that. And see, I have some others. Oh, shoot. Pressing under here. But you can definitely see the little elephant. Whoops. And that's all I did with these, is what I just did with that butterfly of Gina's. And there's one of her flowers stamps. I don't know if you guys can see that because, you know, it's white. And this was the feather. There's a feather. And I'm going to let these dry, and I'll probably come back on here after they dry. And then I had this, I picked this up secondhand, this background stamp. And she embossed. Oh, I may have gotten that one a little too wet. But you could definitely see texture in it. So I'm going to let that dry. And just to demo what I did, let me get that stamp off there. Is, you know, I wet my toilet tissue, I put the butterfly down, and then I gave it a, probably in the camera's way. Sorry for the mess on my table, but I've been trying to reorganize and go through things in my craft room. And then the cuddlebug, you know, has some weight to it along with the book, and I let that set for a little bit. And, let me get those off of that, because I want these to dry, because I'm going to try and do something with these for, you know, officially I'm not on the design team. I'm just helping out with Gina's. I don't know exactly. I just love these stamps, and so I wanted to pop on here to kind of. But I was thinking that maybe we try, you know, she demonstrated in there, in that video, which I will link below. She demonstrated using one of the embossing folders. I'm just trying to find something that's got some detail to it. Oh, here's one. This, what is this? That's this one. And I'm probably going to do the Eiffel Tower here. So, basically, I need some more TP. And this is, this toilet paper is like for septic systems. You know, it's paper, one ply, with no foo-foo or fragrance in it. Try not to buy things with fragrance in there. And again, this is probably about 8 once I get it folded. And I'm going to actually just probably wet it on here. And it's not soaking. It's just damp. I think I made that other one too moist. And then I had my cuddlebug out cutting, but I think I just tossed all this other stuff back in here. And I think I need the 2 B plates and the A plate for it to do maybe it's a C plate. Let me look at it. See what it did. Oh, it's okay. I'm gonna leave it like that. So I'm gonna let that dry. And it'll make a nice collage to go down on something. And, you know, I thought maybe her stamps might be a little, because she's got a lot of detail, but it picked up all the details in that. And the feather Anyways, I'll pop back on here and after I do something with them and show you what I did. I just thought I'd see about trying that. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I just thought I'd pop back on here because I've been doing a little experimenting with doing, I'm embossing on toilet paper, toilet tissue with Gina Erin stamps. And that's just using pressure, under a book. But I thought I'd show you something very interesting. So I've rolled up, it's probably about 8 sheets folded down into this size. Hopefully I'm in camera there or frame. And is what I did is I moistened it a little bit. And let me turn that over. My dog here on there. 3 labs, they're shedders. There we go. And I'm gonna do the feather. Like that, and then I've got 2 B plates here and my A plate, and I'm gonna run it through my cuddle bug. So I went through this way and I went through this way. Once more, and I moved the whole stamp. Maybe I should only do it once because it turned out really well the first time. There's the image of the first time that I did it, and I think I only ran it through the pressure once. And here I did it 3 times and it looks a little smeary and smudgy, like it moved the stamp around a little bit. But that is a gorgeous impression of the stamp. It's got all the details there. And I'm out of toilet paper. I don't know. I wonder what a paper towel would do. Paper towel doesn't have too much. Well, it's got a little texture in it though. But it is thicker. Maybe we'll try that. See what happens. With the paper towel. It's already got some kind of detail on there. Then I did that. And this time I'm going to run it through once. Oops. Lined up. I got the impression, but it didn't come out too well. Let me go get a bit of toilet tissue again, because I was so impressed by it. tried to pop back on here and show you what it did. And this is a 2-ply. And the other that I was using was 1-ply, you know, meant for septic systems. But we'll give it a go and see what happens. Just to see. I thought it was pretty cool. And again, this toilet paper also has a embossed image on it from the store. So. But I was really impressed how that one turned out. I've got a couple of experiments going on here. Like this one, I put a little pink ink, Versamart or something, and then I, after I embossed it down, I put a little Mod Podge over the top of it to see what it does. Yeah, see, that turned out a lot better. I think the toilet tissue is the... I don't know if you guys could see the detail on that. There's a little ink on the stamp, so... but it did do a really good job on it. Okay, I just wanted to pop on and show you that I was running the stamps through the cuddle machine. And the stamp is just fine. Nothing's the matter with the stamp. It did well. It's meant to be under pressure. All right. I'll be back. All right. I'm back. And I just wanted to show you some of my results. Now this was my first ones that I did underneath the book. And they came out okay. I hope you, that's a little too close, isn't it? Let me zoom out just a little. There we go. All right. And they came out okay. I mean, I could see the image there and here. I can see it pretty well. And the flower. And this was the feather. And it's not the best, but you can tell that it was the feather. And that was underneath the pressure of the book and the, you know, weighted down. And then these here, I weighted them down, but it wasn't for just 5 minutes, I think. And, you know, as they're drying, they're coming up and swelling up a little bit. So I'm not really sure what's going to happen. Matter of fact, I'm not sure what's going to happen with any of them. Because it's toilet tissue and, you know, what's going to happen when I put something wet on there. But these were some others that I did. Weighting them down briefly. And... here is a stamp that I did, weighted down. And it did okay. But again, I don't know what's going to happen when it gets re-wet, or I re-wet it. And then I ran the stamps through the cuttle machine like you would a die cut or a die. Not to cut the, but just to put the impression down. And I think it came out a lot better. You know, I can see the image on the back even. It pressed it down so nicely. And there's the feather that I did. And again, this was cranking it through the cuttlebug. This one, and this is once through, because I tried it three times and it moved the stamp around a little bit, and it, you kind of got a blurred image. And that was our paper towel test. They're still not completely dry, but they're dry enough. And there's another one through the cuttlebug. And then I also did the flower and the face. Oh, I'm probably been off. But it did a okay job. I'm just curious to see what happens when I try to put some color down or collage that onto paper. And what else did I do? And there's the embossing folder that I did of the Eiffel Tower. And that turned out really well. And I did the elephant again and the butterfly through the cuttlebug. So I'm still, and this here is, I stamped some Versamark ink down on the stamp before I weighted it down, and it gave it some color. And then I was watered down matte medium that I kind of put over the top of that. So I'm curious to see what happens. And then the little pink elephant here, he's still not quite dry. But again, I went over a little bit with some matte medium to kind of give it a surface. So when I re-wet it, it's just an experiment, and we'll see what happens with that. Okay, I just wanted to pop back on. And this was the one that I got really wet, and it's still very wet. So, you know, I'm not going to toss it out, but, oops, I'm not. But it's still very, very wet. So, that's what I've done so far. I'll be back. Okay, I thought I'd pop back on and show you my finished page with collaging or stamping onto tissue and then collaging it down. This is for Gina Aaron's stamp design. And I just wanted to pop back on here and show you what I've done. Everything seems to be a little messy, crowded. Okay, so, you know, I stamped images onto wet toilet paper, just to recap a little bit, and then colored them, and I collaged them down, and this is my page. And I use little, this here is jelly print that I trimmed off of some jelly prints to put in an envelope to send to somebody, and I kept them. And her dress here is this, I found this at a secondhand store.
And, you know, it's a notepad shaped into a dress. How cool is that, you know? And I just doodled around it with some Jelly Roll pins. I don't know if that's the brand name, but Jill Writer pins. My daughter got for me for a gift. And so there's a lot of sparkle in here using those pins. You know, I may go back in here with a Stabilo All pencil. But I wanted to finish up this video because the design team already has their videos out. And I will certainly link Gina Aaron's video to her. You know, I watched one of her videos about doing this on toilet paper. This is my video take on that. So she was my inspiration for this. And and if you like her stamps and want to know where to get them, I'll link her Etsy shop below too. But these other elements on here, I just thought made a cool contrast. And my quote up here is, "It's okay to dream and play in color." And this here I received in the Round Robin swap box. And so I stuck that down on there. It has nice pretty color in it. I liked it. So that's my page. I wanted to pop back on here and let you know that I finished it so I can upload this video to my YouTube channel, which is Lisa Swank Artful Inspirations on YouTube is my channel. And I'll catch you later. Bye-bye now.